Thank you, Adobe Express, for sponsoring this video. So even if you're not a designer or even if you're not tech savvy, but in this video, you're going to be able to create thumbnails like the one we're going to create here today. So the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go to the description of this video and you want to go ahead and join the free beta of Adobe Express. Now, keep in mind that the beta is only available in the web version. There is a mobile version coming here soon. And if you're watching this video after August 16th, the Adobe Express may be out of beta. So once you go ahead and create your account, you're going to be brought to a dashboard just like this. And what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to select YouTube thumbnail. Now you can go ahead and select here, browse templates, and you're going to see here that Adobe Express is going to give you tons of options to be able to select from of templates they've already come ahead and designed that you can just go ahead and edit really easily. But today we're going to go ahead and focus on creating a Call of Duty thumbnail just like this. And once you learn how to do this the first time, you're going to be able to know how to be able to do this for all kinds of gaming thumbnails that you're going to be creating. So we're going to keep a blank canvas. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to come to media and we're going to be able to go ahead and access tons of images that Adobe gives us, right? So they have stock images that give us high resolution imagery, royalty free stock photos that we're able to utilize. So if you don't have your own images for backgrounds, you can go ahead and utilize Adobe's library. So here I'm going to type in war because we're going to do Warzone, right? So I'm going to look for an image here and I like this one here. So what I'll do is I'm going to just make this the background. So I'm going to make it the full size here. And that's going to be the first thing that we're going to do. So now we have our background in place. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and edit our background to really give it that look that we originally created here. So that way it stands out on YouTube, right? So the first thing we're going to do is you're going to select the image. You're going to come here to where it says adjustments. We're going to go to where it says brightness. And for the brightness, I'm going to say negative 36 just to make it a little bit darker. So you can see it's going to start to pop. For shadows, I'm going to put 5. And then here for the saturation, I'm going to make it really high. So I'm going to put 97. And you're going to see here that's starting to get that orange look, right? So again, to make it pop. Then here where it says sharpness, I'm going to go ahead and put this at about 66. This is going to make it a little bit more high quality. You can see this already starting to pop, right? And then here for the blur, I'm going to put it at 6 because this is going to be the background. So you can see here now how we're starting to begin to build out this thumbnail. So now that we have our background in place, the next thing we want to do is you want to go ahead and bring our gun into the image, right? So this is the gun that we want to bring in. So again, you can go ahead and take a screenshot from your video game where you're holding the gun, any with your skins, just to make it more customizable to you. You can go on Google and find some images, but I just want to show you how you would be able to bring in an image and then be able to remove the background so that you just focus on the actual gun, right? So I'm going to go ahead and utilize an image that I went ahead and got off of Google, but again, you can use any image that you want. I'm going to select here, upload from device, which is going to be on my computer. I'm going to go to my desktop and I'm going to find the image here that I went ahead and found. So you can see here that right now the image has a background on it, but I want to go ahead and remove that. So to be able to do that, I'm going to literally click this button. This is why Adobe Express makes it super easy, because you can go ahead and remove the background and the image pretty quickly, right? So I'm going to go ahead and select remove background. And you're going to see here that it's going to go ahead and remove the background just like that. Pretty simple, right? So now I can go ahead and resize this and make this bigger. And now I can go ahead and start to create this image here, right? So again, we're going to make this a lot bigger. We're going to place this here on the right, and I'm just going to cover that guy that was there initially with the gun, right? And we're going to leave some space for text. However, what we want to do is we want to make this image be a lot brighter. We want it to pop more, right? Just like it does in our original thumbnail here. So to be able to do that, we're going to select the image, and now we're going to go ahead and come here to where it says adjustments, and we're going to do the same thing here, right? So for the contrast, we're going to put this at negative 14. And again, this is going to be adjusted based on what it is that you're doing, based on the thumbnail that you're creating, right? Then here for the highlights, I'm going to go ahead and put that at negative 5. And you're going to see here that it starts to start adjusting here. For sharpness, I'm going to scroll down here. I'm going to go ahead and put it here at 100. You can see it's starting to give it that look. And then for saturation, I'm also going to give it 100. And you can start to see here that it now it's starting to pop, right? So now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and now start adding in our text, right? So we have here where it says buffed, it pops out. So we want to go ahead and create that now, right? So to do that, we're going to come here to the left. We're going to select text, okay? We're going to hit add new text, and you're going to see here that it's going to give us the option here. So this is where we're able, you double click and we're able to type in what we want. So I'm going to go ahead and just type in buffed, right? Because hey, look, this gun is buffed. That's what we want. So I'm just going to center here. And now we can see here that out of the gate, it doesn't look as good, right? But Adobe Express gives you so many options when it comes to fonts that we can easily make this look really nice. So we'll select on the font. Okay, and the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna change the font. Now, one font that I like to use is called Bebes Nunes. Okay, N-E-U-E, and you'll see it here. And I like to use the rounded one. So you can see here that it already gave it the nice look, right? So now, what I wanna do is I wanna go ahead and select that. And here on the left, I want to start making the adjustments. So here, I'm gonna leave it at default. For the fill, I'm gonna make that red. So I'm gonna go custom. I'm going to go red, and I like to go as bright red as I possibly can. And then here on the outline, we're going to go ahead and select white. That's going to give it that nice border. And then as far as for the thickness, I'm going to go ahead and put it at about 16. That gives it a nice little size. And then as far as size of the text, I'm going to go 297. And that's going to go ahead and increase the size here. So 297. Hit enter, and you can see here that now we have it, right? However, you can see here that here it pops out a lot more because we put a background behind it. So to be able to do that, we want to go ahead and come down to where it says shadow, and we want to go ahead and hit smooth, right? Now you can see here that we have it there, but what we want to do is we want to go to color, and we want to select black. And you can see here that now we've created that nice background effect, and you can see here that we've now gone ahead and created this thumbnail, and we can go ahead and now start to download it. So to be able to download this, we're going to hit download. It's going to say PNG, best for images. You're going to hit download, and it's going to go ahead and start downloading, and then you'll have access to the image. But however, now that you created the thumbnail, that's not the only thing you can do with Adobe Express. You can also go ahead and edit videos, your gaming videos, directly in Adobe Express as well, meaning that you can only have to learn one tool to make thumbnails and edit videos. So if you want to know how to edit your gaming videos, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on editing gaming videos directly inside of Adobe Express. I'll see you guys in the next video.